Coastal waters of Alabama are home to species of mammals such as bottlenose dolphins. They're one of the more common mammal species living in our waters. They live in outer coastal waters, bays, inlets, estuaries, and other inland waterways. Challenges dolphins face include large sharks, disease, toxins, food availability, and loss of habitat. Recreational and commercial fisheries affect bottlenose dolphins as well. Some are taken as bycatch in nets and trawls. They are mammals and must come to the surface to breathe. They're warm-blooded, and their young drink milk produced by the mother. Even though their bodies have adapted well to life in the sea and they resemble fish, they really are mammals. Bottlenose dolphins have a single dorsal fin on their back. A dolphin swims with the help of powerful muscles in the rear third of its body, which force the tail up and down to move the animal through the water. Bottlenose dolphins can be seen swimming on their sides. Often their entire body comes out of the water as they leap and splash. Sometimes they surf along the top of the water, which can give them a better view of boats or people nearby. Each dorsal fin of a dolphin has unique markings. These markings are called rake marks and were made by the teeth of other dolphins. Dolphins come to the surface to breathe and must hold their breath when they dive. They cannot breathe through their mouths, but instead use the blowhole at the top of their head. The lungs are emptied and refilled through this blowhole, which prevents water from entering the lungs when they're underwater. It is against the law to feed or interact with wild dolphins. This can change their behavior and make them less likely to survive. If you come upon a stranded marine mammal, such as this bottlenose dolphin, call the regional hotline number and report it. Don't push the animal back to sea. Don't attempt to swim with the animal. And stay with the animal until rescuers arrive. We have trained volunteers and biologists who can appropriately care for live dolphins or recover those that might have died. Some animals are quite large and require several people to move. Special equipment is used to load these animals and haul them to facilities that can either help them recover or do special procedures to take tissue samples if they die. Scientists and volunteers carefully document data on dead dolphins, which will hopefully provide information that will enable them to help dolphins survive and thrive in the world. Another marine mammal species we have in Alabama is the West Indian manatee. If you are near the water, manatees might not be as easy to see as dolphins. Manatees can grow to be quite large and weigh over a ton. They eat aquatic plants and live in the shallow waters of bays, estuaries, and rivers along the coast of the Gulf of Mexico and the Caribbean. They have very slow metabolisms and move to warm water when water temperature drops below 70 degrees. The skin of manatees is very thick and wrinkled. Manatee mothers produce milk for their babies and the young nurse under pectoral limbs of their mothers. They're able to do this while the mom is swimming. Can you spot the mother and baby in this image? Look in the upper right portion of the photograph. This is a reminder for boaters. You may see a nose sticking up, or maybe a mother and baby are resting just inches below the surface. Watercraft or boat collision is the single largest cause of manatees' death. When they surface to breathe or rest at the surface, they are very vulnerable to be hit by a boat. Using caution in areas where manatees are known to live is vital to their survival. A common place to see manatees in our area is in Mobile Bay, especially under the bayway. Because they are slow-moving, boaters must use extreme caution if manatees are in their path. They cannot move quickly like dolphins. Their seal-like bodies have a paddle-shaped tail and two flippers, which are used for locomotion and for holding food. Manatees winter in the warm water of Florida Springs. When the air and water temperature begins to drop in Alabama, they head south for warmer water, and many gather around power plant outflows where the water is very, very warm. Manatees emit sounds underwater that are especially common between mothers and calves. They have fairly good vision. Manatees sleep along the bottom and can stay underwater for as long as 20 minutes while sleeping. If they're swimming, they may surface every 30 seconds to breathe, but usually while they're feeding, they breathe every 3 to 5 minutes. Biologists can use breathing rates to learn about manatee behavior. Manatees are gentle, curious creatures. They might approach a boat or a paddleboard or kayak, but laws regulating how humans interact with them are very strict. Because they are an endangered species, it is against the law to harass a manatee in any way. This includes following them, interfering between a mother and baby, or mating animals, or disturbing their sleep. Dauphin Island Sea Lab participates in a satellite tagging program so migration of manatees from Florida to Alabama can be monitored and laws governing their safety can be adjusted and as needed for their protection. After they are tagged, the Sea Lab staff observes from a distance. If you see a beacon like this moving through the water, you must leave it alone. Some manatees are released after being injured and cared for, and human interaction is not good for them. And in fact, it's illegal. Manatees do not have natural enemies, and they're not generally fearful. They can be found chewing algae off of anchor ropes or mooring lines, so boaters have to be very careful. Their skin can be bumpy and have layers of algae growing on it. Newborn calves generally weigh between 60 and 70 pounds. They can swim to the surface on their own after being born and can vocalize at or soon after birth. The snout of the manatee has stiff whiskers and short hairs that can be found all along their bodies. Their front flippers have 3 to 4 nails each that reminds us of their closest land animal relative, the elephant. And while they use their paddle-shaped tail for their primary means of movement, they also walk along the bottom using their front flippers. Many manatees have scars from collisions with boat hulls and propellers, and while not all are deadly, serious injury and death often occurs. Boaters must use extreme caution as these animals stay very close to the surface and are slow swimmers. Many manatees have died or been seriously wounded due to propellers and boat hull impacts. This is not how we want to see manatees. It's so much better to see them alive and doing well. total number of dolphin deaths for the states of Alabama, Mississippi, and Louisiana spiked in the years 2010 and 11, and still today, the average number of deaths is higher than it was before 2010. The Florida manatee, which is the subspecies that visits Alabama during the summer months, has also had a spike in the number of deaths beginning in 2010, and this year in 2013, we've had another large spike due to red tide. We need to do everything possible to protect marine mammal species. Clean water is one of the first and foremost things they need to survive. If you see a manatee, please call the Manatee Sighting Network at the Dauphin Island Sea Lab. If you see a dolphin or any marine mammal that's injured, stranded, or dead, please call. Visit the Dauphin Island Sea Lab to learn more about your coastal ecosystems.